COVID-19 pandemic has, you know, hit the world on multiple dimensions. I mean, the economic progress setbacks have gotten a lot of headlines, but it's also been a massive setback to the progress towards the SDGs. And on different dimensions, you know, gender, poverty, health, hunger, nutrition, education. I mean, there's been disruption on all fronts. And unfortunately, it's the poor and vulnerable who've been hit the hardest. We were really badly hit, particularly by the second wave. But to me, India actually presents a really striking example of a whole of society approach that really helped us, ramp up the national response at a time of great need. And this really required the government at the central and state level, voluntary organizations, philanthropy, and private sector all coming together. And I think the government leadership in particular was unified and quite exemplary, led by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, but very strong contributions from the Department of Biotechnology on vaccines, from the railways on oxygen transportation, on the Niti Aayog and external affairs for international support. The Home Ministry, of course, which was overseeing all of this because, India's response was governed by the Disaster Management Act. Civil aviation with the Vande Bharat flights, textiles on PPE and, so it's really all parts of government. And it's really, particularly when I talk about vaccines, I think it's the decades of investment in health and the vaccine R&D that is paying off for us. We've delivered over 80 crore vaccines and all of them have been domestically produced. And now the government indicates that exports will also resume soon. And a particularly notable role for the thousands and actually the millions of women in self-help groups who came together to join this national response, the production of PPEs, sanitizers, masks, in many places getting involved with delivering meals and making sure that people who needed care at home, they had support, access to benefits. We were very fortunate to be able to partner with the government. So we looked at the areas where we can contribute. We worked both at the central level as well as in the states of UP and Bihar, where the foundation has been active for several years. We supported efforts to expand testing, surveillance, on the vaccine side. R&D for new and repurposed drugs, and then strengthening the community response in the two states, particularly UP and Bihar, where we contributed to, expanding the healthcare infrastructure, supporting digital tools, and then just expanding the on-ground work for risk communications and community engagement with partners like UNICEF, WHO, and others. A notable contribution I do want to call out is the partnership we entered into with the Serum Institute of India and Gavi to accelerate at-risk manufacturing and delivery of approximately 300 million doses, 200 million doses of the Covishield vaccine and now about 100 million doses of Covovax, which will be available for India and the world. We also engaged with a wide ecosystem of partners, including philanthropy. Give India's India COVID Relief Fund and then ACT Grants, which was again a constellation of startup entities coming together to support India's response. So COVID-19 has disrupted, all of our lives in unimaginable ways. But now is really the time to begin laying the groundwork for what a healthy and resilient future should look like for all Indians. The government is leading the way and we are privileged and ready to contribute in our own way.